Hey, it is Dave from Gravity Whiz. Today, I am very pleased to be able to introduce you to the Entries Loop. It has been completely reimagined in Entry Blocks Beta 1, and I think you're gonna love it. Let's jump in. First things first, we're gonna add a Gravity Forms Entries top level block to the page. That's what's gonna give you access to all of the entry blocks at your disposal. We're gonna select from the form here, team directory, which has some sample data that I've already generated. And we're going to select the entries loop as the layout we want to use. With the entries loop in place, you'll see that it loads all of our entries and they're using the all fields merge tag to just output all of their data along with a view and edit URL for those entries. This doesn't look the best, but you'll notice that when we click on it, we can immediately start customizing this. Pretty cool. So I'm gonna type in curly brace to pull up our merge tag menu. This is what will give you access to all of the entry data. And I'm gonna go ahead and just select first name and we'll go curly brace again and select the last name. And one really cool thing you can see here is that as we are typing all of the other blocks here, all of the other blocks within this entries loop are being updated. Before we go any further, I actually wanna go ahead and switch this entries loop into grid view, because I know that I'm gonna display a grid 2x2. So I'll go to columns and go to reduce that to 2 columns. And I said 2x2, but what I meant was it's just gonna be 2 columns and it will just go repeat into infinity for each of the entries that are available. And now you'll also be able to see that as we make changes, you'll be able to see those reflected more easily. So now I am looking at this, I'm thinking it's looking okay. Maybe we'll move the edit link up next to this. But there's a couple things I wanna do. I'm gonna put an image in here and I wanna also maybe put like the job title. And I just feel like it's gonna look really good if we could put some columns. So I'm gonna do a column block and I'm gonna go with the 1/3, 2/3 split. I'm gonna go ahead and grab these paragraphs, oops, right here. And I'm gonna put those into that first column. And then I'm gonna cheat a little bit because I know I wanna add this image. So I'm gonna go ahead and get the merge tag for that image. And then I'm gonna go over to the 1/3 block and I'm gonna type in the image to find the image block. And then you can't quite see this, but this says insert from URL. And we're gonna paste in the headshot 11. This is mapped to a file upload field on the form. And we're gonna submit that and you're gonna see that it returns the URL. And so therefore that image field can populate the URL. And you're just getting these really nice looking images. And so that's the gist of it. But I'm like, oh yeah, I wanna also put in a job title. So let's do extra curly brace to get the job title. And that's looking pretty good, but I wanna actually style this a little bit. And so what's really cool is you can use the block styles to control the style of the content. So let's go to text and we'll select this little default color here. And I realize that it's a little far away from the actual name of the person. And so I wanna reduce the margin on that to 0 and bring that in nice and tight. And now again, we click off, we can see how it looks and it's looking really good. Now, there's no way it will look this good on the front end, right? There's always gotta be, It actually does. And that, for me, in a nutshell, is the beauty of this new entries loop, is that it truly is what you see is what you get. And it has just been such a joy to test and work with. I'm legitimately excited about this. There's a lot more that we can do here. This is, again, just a very simple demo. But I want to show you this other really cool demo that I cooked up here. This is also this same idea of a team directory, but I went a little fancier here. You can see I have used a group to break this whole section out of the default content width. And you can also see that when I click on these though, they are still editable in the same way that I just demonstrated. You're just using merge tags to tell which content it should put where, and you can use any block that's available with WordPress to, or the block editor, to output that content. In this case, we also added the bio, so you can see a little bit more about them. And then we created our own custom link here that links to their single entry view. And if we jump over here, we can click this view entry. We can get a little teaser of what that single entry view looks like. Unfortunately, this one doesn't show you the data live like the entries loop does, but we are planning on adding support for that in the future. But you can see just again how this template is laid out. It looks pretty nice. And if we go and view this on the front end, again, you see that it just looks just like it does in the editor. And then if we click to learn more, you can see that that data is also populated. So that is the entries loop and even entry blocks itself in a nutshell. I'm really excited about this release. I really hope that you are too. And I'm really excited to see what you do with this. Make a point to share your experience with us. We love to hear from our customers. All right, thank you so much. Again, this is Dave from GravityWYSIWYG, and I am very excited to hear from you soon. Bye.